It's now 6:30 in the morning and you're listening to UME Radio, WMEDB New York. It's 6:30 a.m. and it's now time for this day in history. Today is January 7, 2020. Wow, the days are moving. They're just moving fast. Okay, so on January 6th, on January 7, the first U.S. presidential election occurred. Congress sets January 7, 1789 as the date by which states are required to choose electors for the country's first ever presidential election. A month later, on February 4, George Washington was elected president by state electors and sworn into office on April 30, 1789. As it did in 1789, the United States still uses the Electoral College system established by the U.S. Constitution, which today gives all American citizens over the age of 18 the right to vote for electors, who in turn vote for the president. The president and vice president are the only elected federal officials chosen by the Electoral College instead of by direct popular vote. Today, political parties usually nominate their slate of electors at their state conventions or by a vote of the party's central state committee, with party loyalists often being picked for the job. Members of the U.S. Congress, though, can't be electors. Each state is allowed to choose as many electors as it has senators and representatives in Congress. During a presidential election year, on election day, the first Tuesday after the first Monday in November, the electors from the party that gets the most popular votes are elected in a winner-take-all system, with the exemption of Maine and Nebraska, which allocate electors proportionally. In order to win the presidency, a candidate needs a majority of 270 electoral votes out of a possible 538. So on this day in history, on January 7, 1789, the first U.S. presidential election was held. Keep listening to UME Radio.